All right, listeners, get ready for takeoffs, because on this deep dive, we are going virtual. We're flying over some seriously epic scenery in South America.
Yeah, you guys sent in some pretty cool flight details, so we're going to break down why this route is so special.
Exactly. Think massive volcanoes, ancient secrets etched into the earth, and dramatic coastlines where the desert plunges right into the sea.
It's definitely not your average sightseeing flight.
Right, so our journey begins high up in the Andes Mountains.
Oh, yeah.
We're talking Quito, Ecuador, the Mariscal Sucre International Airport.
Now, that's a starting point that'll get your heart racing, I'm telling you.
Okay, so I'm already imagining looking out the window during takeoff and seeing those massive snow-capped peaks all around. Talk about an epic start to a trip.
Talk about an adrenaline rush. You're literally taking off from an airport that's nestled among some of the highest peaks in the world.
And speaking of peaks, next up on our virtual flight plan is Cotopaxi Volcano. What makes this one so special?
Well, first off, it's one of the highest active volcanoes anywhere.
Yeah,
you heard that right. Active. So not only is Cotopaxi famous for that almost perfectly symmetrical cone shape and that snow-capped peak that just draws you in.
Yeah, it's picture perfect.
It's also got a bit of a fiery personality.
Oh, really?
Yeah, back in 1877, it had a major eruption and the mud flows traveled over 60 miles. Can you imagine?
That's both incredible and a little bit terrifying. Mother Nature at her finest.
Exactly. It really puts things into perspective.
All right, so far we've had breathtaking mountains, a potentially erupting volcano. What's next on this amazing journey?
Well, prepare for a mystery, because we're about to fly over one of archaeology's biggest enigmas, the Nazca Lines in Peru.
Oh yeah, the Nazca Lines, I've heard of those. Aren't those the giant drawings in the desert?
Giant is an understatement. We're talking massive geoglyphs etched into the desert floor that are only visible from the air.
So what kinds of things are we talking here?
Well, imagine a hummingbird with a wingspan over 200 feet long, a spider that stretches almost 150 feet. You've got monkeys, fish, even what some people believe looks like a spaceman.
A spaceman? What?
Yeah, it's wild. And the craziest part is we still don't know for sure why they were created.
Serious?
Some researchers think they're astronomical calendars. Others believe they were part of religious rituals, maybe used to communicate with the gods.
It just blows my mind thinking about these massive drawings being there for centuries, and we're still trying to figure out their meaning.
Yeah.
It really makes you think about the people who created them, their beliefs, their understanding of the world.
That's the beauty of it, right? We get this glimpse into their world, this puzzle that continues to fascinate and challenge us.
Okay, so we've had ancient cultures' mysterious lines, and now I hear our next stop. The Paracas Peninsula has its own share of secrets.
Oh, yeah. While the contrast of those reddish desert cliffs against the deep blue Pacific is visually stunning.
Yeah, I bet the sunset views are amazing.
It's a photographer's dream, but the Paracas Peninsula is more than just a pretty face. It also holds archaeological treasures.
Like what?
Ancient tombs have been discovered there, containing incredibly well-preserved textiles and artifacts, some dating back thousands of years.
Wow, so we're talking about a glimpse into the lives and culture of the people who thrived in this challenging environment so long ago.
Exactly.
So we've got ancient cultures, mysterious lines, incredible textiles, hidden away in tombs. It's like peeling back layers of history with every stop on this flight. And finally, we touch down in Lima, Peru, at the Jorge Chavez International Airport.
Ah, Lima, a vibrant coastal city.
I bet the views on approach are something else.
Absolutely. As you descend into Lima, you get this incredible panoramic view of the city stretched along the coastline with that vast desert as a backdrop. It's a truly unforgettable sight.
So from soaring volcanic peaks to ancient mysteries and breathtaking coastal views, this virtual flight has been a whirlwind of incredible sights and intriguing history.
It really highlights the incredible diversity of South America, its landscapes, its cultures. It's a place that just keeps on giving.
It really makes you wonder what other natural wonders and archaeological treasures are still out there waiting to be discovered.
That's the beauty of exploration, right? There's always more to uncover, more to understand, more to appreciate.
To our listeners, if you ever get the chance to experience this flight in real life, jump at it. It's a journey that will stay with you long after you've landed. And until our next deep dive, keep exploring.
Happy travels.
Bye.
Bye.
This exit, which may be behind you. En caso de evacuación, deje sus pertenencias a bordo.
In an event of an evacuation, leave your personal belongings on board.
Encontrará su chaleco salvavidas debajo de su asiento o bajo el apoyabrazo central. Retírelo de la bolsa. Páselo sobre su cabeza. Abrocha la cinta en la parte delantera y ajústela a la cintura. Al salir del avión, inflelo tirando la manilla roja o soplando por la boquilla.
A life vest can be found underneath your seat or below the central armrest. Remove it from the bag, slip it over your head, fasten the belt at the front, and adjust it at the waist. As you leave the aircraft, inflate your vest by pulling on the red handle or blowing into the tube.
Una luz se activa al contacto con el agua.
A light will turn on upon contact with the water.
Si la cabina pierde presión, máscaras caerán automáticamente sobre su asiento.
If the cabin loses pressure, masks will automatically drop down from above your seat.
Tome la máscara, colóquela sobre su nariz y boca, deslice la banda elástica alrededor de su cabeza, ajústela y respire normalmente. Coloque su propia máscara antes de asistir a niños u otras personas.
Pull the mask toward you, place it over your nose and mouth, secure the elastic band behind your head, and breathe normally. Put on your own mask first before assisting children or others.
En caso de requerir mayor información, le invitamos a leer nuestra tarjeta con información de seguridad ubicada en el bolsillo frente a usted.
If you need more information, you are welcome to take a look at our safety information card located at the seat pocket in front of you.
Gracias por su atención y disfrute su vuelo con LATAM.
Thank you for your attention and enjoy your flight with LATAM.